Ever wondered if renting a powerful cloud GPU is better than using a local GPU? This doesn't only relate to performance, but also to costs, including electricity. Is it really worth it? Local GPU prices are climbing new heights, and sometimes it's even difficult to get one, like the current NVIDIA 5000 series, and electricity is far from being cheap. On the other hand, AI models are growing in size and complexity, demanding more GPU performance and VRAM. Hence, in my last video, I've shown you how to install and use ComfUI, a tool for image and video generation on an online GPU. And as promised, in today's video, we will compare the performance of local and online GPUs and their costs. Which online and local GPUs are worth the price? Some of the results might surprise you. There are obvious pros and cons for using online versus local GPUs. Your local GPU is always available, doesn't depend on your internet speed, and electricity is the only variable cost. On the other hand, you have high upfront costs, and what if your local GPU isn't sufficient for your AI tasks? With cloud GPUs, there's no extra power bill and you get higher-end hardware instantly. You can upgrade on demand and often pay as you go. But cloud GPUs come with a price, and these prices vary. Moreover, you depend on the internet, and there may even be queue times. But the decisive factors where you don't have an alternative are the following. Privacy. If you plan to use confidential data with an AI, you have to use a local AI with a local GPU. Well, online providers differ in privacy rules and contracts, but if you want to be sure, there is no choice. VRAM. Some models and workflows demand an amount of VRAM that goes beyond the 32 GB of a 5090 and far beyond what more inexpensive local GPUs offer. In this case, an online GPU is the way to go. Similarly for time constraints. If you simply can't afford long waiting times or have strict deadlines for your AI processes, then you need the highest performance. If you don't want to set up your own server park with high-end GPUs, cloud GPUs are the solution. But if the decisive factors don't apply to you so clearly, how do you come to a decision? That's why we'll take a closer look at the performance and costs. Comparing GPUs regarding costs and performance for AI depends on benchmarks. I wanted one benchmark with nearly 100% GPU workload and a second one that stresses both the GPU and VRAM. In fact, I found that the ComfUI GPU benchmark, which can be found in the ComfUI GitHub discussions, covers the first. When iterating the sampling steps, we have nearly 100% GPU workload, and in the discussions, a lot of results for various GPUs can be found for comparison. For the second benchmark, I've chosen Hanyuan video generation with a reduced resolution so that it can be run even on local GPUs below a 5090. It depends much more on VRAM size than image generation. For accumulating test data about costs and performance of online GPUs, I've used the platform Lightning AI, which I covered in my last video. It's one of the reasonably priced platforms and offers access that is in general quite close to a local PC. Moreover, it offers different GPU types for different prices, which fits to our comparison tasks. My previous video describes in detail how I've set up the workflows for both benchmarks, and you can even download the workflows and try them yourself. That being said, as I only own an AMD RX 6800, I had to derive estimated video benchmarks from the ComfUI benchmarks, the actual results of the online GPUs, and my RX 6800. Therefore, the results may not be completely exact, but the general direction should be correct and provide a good guide. The same is true for the power consumption, where I had to take the results of my GPU as a basis using This small device for measurement and adjusting my estimations, along with the figures like TGP, total graphics power, which can be found online. The Google Sheet containing all results and calculations can be accessed from my Patreon for free. There is no paywall and all links are in the description. If you want to help improving the quality of the calculations, please run the benchmarks with your GPU and post the results in the comments so that I can update the Google Sheet. It's perfectly fine if you do this without measuring the power, but if you do, then it would be even more helpful. And if you don't have the opportunity to carry out a measurement or benchmark, a like is also helpful. Before we continue with the graphical chart showing the results, some remarks on how to use the Google Sheet regarding power consumption. In this cell, you enter the price for 1 kilowatt. I've added a link to country averages. In the UK and Germany, it's 35 cents. That's the default value I've used in the following charts. And for example, in the US, the average price is 18 cents, about half the price. So please pay attention to this cell. Additionally, there is a cell for the system workload without GPU. For my system, it's 120 watts. You can use this value if you don't want to calculate or measure it for your own system. I have limited my GPU to 200 watts instead of the TGP of 250. So the power consumption for my system under load is 320 watts. Moreover, I've noticed that the GPU utilization for video generation is closer to 80% than to 100%, which I covered in this cell. I assume the reason is the decoding process and possibly moving the models between RAM and VRAM. For Hanyun Video, you will find one result with the RX 6800 for Linux and two for SLUDA on Windows. The reason is the resulting video was corrupted when using the GPU for the so-called VAE decode and not only the CPU. I still left both results in because they might still be interesting for you. Here comes the fun part. We have the performance results for the ComfUI benchmark. Queue times are shown in red and iterations per second in blue. Regarding AMD GPUs, my RX 6800 cannot compete with the field, especially not with LUDA. The newer RX 7900 XTX does much better. Among NVIDIA GPUs, it's no surprise. The 4090 is the fastest. Alas, I don't have any results from a 5090, but according to my information, it isn't much faster than a 4090. In the online GPU section, the T4 with 16GB VRAM is the slowest, while the L40S with 48GB VRAM is even faster than a 4090 and most likely faster than the 5090 too. Looking at the Hanyuan video benchmark, the cloud GPUs do a much better job, except for the T4, and my RX 6800 doesn't do too well. Please remember, times for the other local GPUs are estimated. I'd assume the 5090's performance is closer to that of the L4. Moreover, VRAM size isn't considered, especially since 8GB GPUs might struggle to render the videos. Let's wait for some viewers to post the results in the comments, then we will have a clearer picture. Nevertheless, for rough cost estimations, this should be good enough. As a side note, Hanyuan Video is designed for a resolution of 1280 by 720, but my GPU was not capable of rendering it. So here are the results for the L4 and the L40S. Even the L40S required more than 10 minutes. In this graphic, the hourly costs for local GPUs are based solely on power consumption. GPU VIA and the like aren't taken into account. You can adjust the electricity prices. By default, I've used the averages from the UK and Germany in the Google Sheet. For the cloud GPUs, we have a price tag for 1 hour of usage. Looking at the chart, online GPUs aren't worth it at all, are they? Well, of course, we still have to consider the performance here. We calculate the cost of each processing cycle so you can see how much each generated image or video really costs. And then the following picture emerges in the ComfUI benchmark. Blue bars represent iteration prices. Now let's look at the red prices for 1000 images. For image generation, at least with SDXL, cloud GPUs aren't worth it, and the NVIDIA RTX 5080 offers the best price performance ratio. So let's look at the more complex and VRAM intensive generation of Hanyuan videos. The online T4 is clearly too weak for the price and skews our chart, so we'll zoom in a little. Here it is clear that the Cloud L4 and L40S have a better price performance ratio than my local RX 6800. So for VRAM intensive applications, it is better for me to use an online GPU. The other local GPUs, on the other hand, beat the online GPUs, provided they can actually generate the videos. But is it really that simple? Here you can see the number of videos you could generate for the purchase price of the GPUs using an L40S. Simply put, if you need less, the local GPU isn't worth it. Taking into account the purchase price and electricity costs, using the 5090 as an example, almost 65,000 benchmark videos would need to be generated. However, that is only half the truth. You probably want to create 720p videos, which cost around 50 cents each. In case generating around 5000 videos with a 5090 would likely make it worth it. If you find the video useful and would like to see more videos with me, please subscribe to my channel. So, what is the result of the tests and measurements? If you only use AI every now and then, you don't need to buy a powerful GPU. It is cheaper to buy a few online hours, at least when the free hours have been used up. If you use AI very often, then a local GPU is actually the better solution, always assuming that the performance and VRAM are sufficient for your needs. Then it may even be advisable to buy one of the very expensive GPUs. Let me know in the comments, do you use a local or cloud GPU?